you wouldn't know who I am, would you?
No.
So Miss Williams I am. All right, so open hands up. David, we won't begin with a song called St. David's because we haven't got power. next, I believe. So, our computer's back working. And our piano. So if we have my class at first, please. Come this way, this way.
Delphi McDonald's.
Delphi Jiu-Jitsu.
Fel chi nofio, newch chi gyda hain.
Newch chi pob.
Newch chi siopio.
Newch chi wedi athlo.
Newch chi awos a daba tawa.
Thank you.
Yeah.
year three's coming. You're coming this way? Pops, go that way, there we are. Fantastic actors, cream of the crop, Philip Beer. Fantastic.
Thank you.
volleyball school after hearing that. That was incredible. If we go around this way, if we can just go around that way, and then we'll get you five coming up here. Fabulous.
Thank you. Unfortunately, the story may have more to do with tourism than truth. from a little bird. When, in 1793, a man called David Pritchard came to live in that garret. He was the landlord of the Royal Boat Inn, now the Royal Boat Hotel.
He made a Welsh legend about a dog named Kilhart buried at Beth Garrett. Now, with the story of a brave dog whose master thinks he has killed his baby son.
Making up the name of Gellert, he adapted to fit the village.
His aim was to increase trade at the inn.
It is now an ancient memorial put in place long ago by a group of remorseful prince. The grave is actually quite new, just over 200 years old.
It was an attempt to boost northern landowners to the village and cross line their property.
So, is there any truth in the tale?
Well, it is certainly true that hunting with dogs was a popular and important sport for the nobility in medieval times.
During Fulton, that's currently a great one with punishment by death, a punishment equivalent to that for murder.
Thank you.
wonderful, wasn't it? Hear the Welsh and the English together. Now then, we're going to move on to something very special. I'm going to send them line over with pwysig iawn. Alice is all going to help me be dyfa. She's going to help me with it. So, a bard. And well, pwysig with Diana, let's see. Thank you. I've really enjoyed this afternoon. You've really cheered up a really wet and gloomy day, and I've enjoyed all of the performances that we've seen. You've all worked really, really hard, so thank you for that. You've cheered me up on a miserable day. We've come to the end of our Ice Stepford now, and it is the tradition that at the end of the Ice Stepford, there is a special award. And the special award is given to a writer. Sometimes it can be a writer of a story, sometimes it can be a writer of a play, sometimes it can be a writer of a poem. And this week, all the children in Year 6 have been preparing for that award. They've been busily in class writing poems. They listened to the story of Gellert, the story that Mrs. Cosgrove's class told you, and their task was to adapt that story into a narrative poem. Not an easy task at all. And they also had quite a challenging list of extras to put into their narrative poem to make it stand out. They had to show off their poetry writing skills. And I know when I was walking around the classroom, I was delighted with what I was seeing. I was looking over the shoulders and I was going, oh, wow, oh, that's wonderful. And some children really, really surprised me. And I know Mrs. Cosgrove, she said the same. So well done to all of your sets. You worked really, really hard. The judges this year had a difficult task to choose just one winner. Normally, it's easy. Normally, we know straight away, oh, it's that poet. That's got to be the winner. But that wasn't the case this year. We really, really had to reread some of the poems, make a little list on each poem of what the writer had achieved. So I'm going to call out three people. And there's only going to be one winner, but it was so close between these three, I think the three people deserve a mention. It's Patricia from Mrs. Cosgrove's class. If you'd like to come out, Patricia, please. And from year 6H, it will be Stevie M and Bethan, please. So, I really want to say well done to the three of you. You can all three of you be very, very proud for standing here. It's a great achievement. And it was really, really hard to choose just one. But the judges, after a long, long time of looking through it and thinking hard, we did finally come up with one winner, and that is Steve Matthews. Holding all the winners of the Bard from each Ice Stepford, their names are engraved on that. And when I look at them, I can remember teaching, oh, I remember him, I remember her, I remember her. And Steve's name is going to be added now to that shield. And I'm sure Steve, in a few years' time, I'll look at it and I think, oh, I remember Steve. He was in my class.
And he was a very talented writer indeed, a very talented writer. So it's traditional now at the end of the Eisteddfod for the bard winner to be serenaded by some Welsh music and some Welsh dancers. Singers we've got in this school. And then it was beautiful. It was so lovely to see you. So I'd like to, would you like to hear from us? Thank you very much.
Boys and girls, it's been an absolute delight to sit here this afternoon and certainly to look at all the wonderful Welsh talent we have in this room from our lovely friends in reception who started off so well, Danielle. Magnificent, right through to our children in year six, with year one, year two, year three, four, five in between. Excellent, because there we heard some of the greatest things that we have, the greatest talents we have in Wales. We heard some poetry, we heard drama, we saw some acting, we saw some singing, some dancing, all those things that the Welsh people are renowned for, with all the history that came into it, and all the sporting triumphs that we have, and all the wonderful use of the Welsh language as well. So da iawn, pa, well done everyone, that was really fantastic. Can we give ourselves a